arms.
That would be Sabrina.
Why me?
You're special, aren't you? Half witch, half mortal, representing the two tribes to be terminus.
This would explain my new powers.
New powers?
I've recently tapped into new magics, new energies, resurrection, healing, control over the weather. I'm not sure I can be killed.
Right.
And he has new powers. So that's kind of dumb to send your fucking scarecrow out there to get murdered yourself.
Hey.
She would literally tear him apart, babe.
Weight of the world on your shoulders, you don't have to bear that.
That's the phoenix right there.
Nick.
Our academy attacked by the false gods, hunters. And most recently, the Witch's Council has turned its back on us. The Church of Night is gone. We are now the Church of Judas. And you must look to the five tenets of Judas for salvation and exaltation. The Academy will adopt these beliefs immediately. Learn them, do not deviate from them, and we will once again know satanic greatness.
I woke up today feeling excited. Excited to be here, to be alive.
Who is this person?
Ooh. Okay.
Get this in hand. Auntie, will you make me my favorite for breakfast? Blueberry pancakes?
Truth or dare. She's about to hit that smile.
What the fuck is going on?
What's the meaning of this? Elspeth fled, Father Blackwood. Even beyond our walls, the heretic Sabrina Spellman threatens our dominion. So find her, kill her, and bring me her head.
Damn. Okay.
What is going on with Sabrina?
Is something wrong?
If so I was her friend, I'd be like, you never speak like this in your entire life. Like, this whole tone of voice.
I can
like,
change
what's
your body.
Yeah.
I don't need to change my body to feel like a boy. Theo, only a friend will tell you this.
So the only one left is Nick.
You're not Nick.
How do you know that? You must have known what it is.
I tried banishing it.
It's Wardwell, Nick. It's been Wardwell pulling the strings this whole time.
That was about time.
Finally got it, girl. Finally got it.
Sabrina. Nicholas. Where are you going?
I'm going to find and kill my double. And then I'll be back to kill you.
Oh, yeah.
Sabrina, wait. Sorry, Herbie.
Okay then.
At the place where we were born.
Do you mean the place that you were born, which is in our basement? Or do you mean the place that I was born?
Right. And why do we gotta wait so many hours? Can't we just go do this now?
Right.
What do you got planned before tonight? You gotta go buy a gun?
What do you mean?
What was the Nazarene's last act? He sacrificed himself. And what is the ultimate perversion of a sacrifice? Suicide.
Holy shit.
You can't beat the Dark Lord at this game.
There's more.
More?
Prophecy. And once he walks on Earth, the girl will rule at his side. And the new dawn will begin.
hurt her soul.
Mr. Scratch, we must stop Sabrina before she dooms us all. No! Hilda!
6, 7, 8, 9
She cheated.
It wasn't suicide.
Sabrina.
Kinda
that was
is.
The last step.
Kill yourself.
To complete the prophecy.
Kill yourself. It was the final perversion. What do you say?
Oh, jeez.
The prophecy is being fulfilled. The end of days is upon us. The Dark Lord will walk the earth in his true form. The gates of hell will open, and you will sit by his side and rule as his queen.
All right, that was episode 8 of Sabrina, and you know, to me, I'm like, look, it was a lot wrong in there, and it was a lot of things that was right in there. A lot of things I don't understand, I didn't get, but from a story point of view, I guess, you know, they had to do what they had to do, because some of the nonsense of the powerful Sabrina, she just could have ended this whole thing if she wanted to. We didn't have to have all this conversation.
But I feel like they addressed that when Ambrose was telling Sabrina that it's like a newborn baby, she doesn't know how to strategize, so she's like,
yeah,
super nuanced and like,
that is true,
not
is
really
true.
Not fully developed, so like she's like a child, so
yeah.
she wouldn't think that far ahead.
That's true. Well, I'm not gonna nitpick it, the show out of that, all of that, but the last episode, this was a build up to the final episode that's coming. Obviously, now she fulfilled all the prophecies, come to find out. She does know Miss Wardwell is behind all of the damn things that she told her to do, which is finally good. Ambrose was helping her out on that. Then you got the aunties. They in a whole heap of shit, because they just damn killed one of the high priest council members on there. And the last episode is probably about to be how you gonna stop the apocalypse from coming, but I don't know how they came.
So I always like a good prophecy. I'm like a fan of the prophecy. So I liked Nick having gone and found the footnote in the book. I like how it was, we knew Miss Wardwell was guiding her, but I liked having it vocalized in the way that she was having her do each one of these perversions, which ultimately was fulfilling the prophecy. I liked the end where it was suicide and in a way that she killed herself using the mandrake. I thought that was clever. Volstis, or whatever his name is completely, like, all the way up to the most misogynistic he could possibly be at this point.
He's so over the top.
I don't know how he's being able to be so reckless and enact all these things. Are there nobody that holds him accountable? Like,
it's annoying he's so reckless,
like,
right now.
It's annoying that no one, like, that
and
he's
then,
just able to do it.
And of all the years the Church of Night has been around, of dark magic and the witches has been around, and we've gotten to the point that we got to now. All
and
of a sudden, now we can just one
go
thing,
all the way back to,
and there's nobody to be like, hey, dog, look, we took a long time to get what we got.
Right,
dog.
And you just get to enact your 5 rule book thing, and
makes
like
no
we
sense.
Just have to do it. Like,
again,
how is this a thing?
No sense.
That's dumb.
Yeah, makes no sense.
That's annoying, and the whole having your son marry your daughter so that you could have ultimate black. Water
it is over the top.
It's so ridiculous.
It
it's
over
so
ridiculous.
I just want him off the show. I'm
is
over
it. Is this or is this ain't in now times? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They acting like this is 1874 we up here.
Or
right
he's
now.
Like he wants it to be.
Like, Jesus. Like, come
even
on.
Even the freaking statue he...
of Judas.
Of him. Literally...
I think that's Judas.
No, I think
it didn't really look like him.
No, I think it's him.
Oh, okay.
And having, like, the women at his feet, like, basically, I'm just like, you are so annoying. I literally want you to die.
He's so over the top with the misogyny. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's insane. I'm excited to see the finale to see what ultimately the prophecy means. Like, is he really going to come up? Is she really going to be the queen? Like, is she going to be manipulated?
Not.
Like,
yeah.
How is that going to happen?
Yeah, I mean, are we about to take the Dark Lord out of the whole game, period?
I mean,
you
can't.
Yeah, like... So it's something
we'll
up to be like that, I guess.
We'll have to wait and see what happens.
Yeah. All right, well, look, thank you guys again for watching another Real Talk Reaction for Sabrina Season 3.
Two.
Episode, season two.
Episode eight.
Three is next. Episode number eight. And until next time, people. Peace. And we'll shine vibe in the air. Let's go! I got the beat, I be locked down. Cause I'm the hardest dude in the club right now. She got the beat, I be locked down. Cause she the best chick in the club right now.
I got the VIP locked down. I'm the baddest chick in the club right now. He got the VIP locked down. Cause he the hottest dude in the club right now.
Look, I'm on the guest list, walking past these.